In this video, I will be showing you how to accelerate a secondary hard disk drive with an Intel Optane memory. So most of us have doubt that an Intel Optane memory can only accelerate a hard drive when an operating system is installed. However, this is not true. Now Intel Optane can also accelerate a secondary hard disk drive wherein operating system is not installed. So I will be using this Intel Optane memory kit to accelerate my secondary hard disk drive, which I will be using to store all my bigger files like games and videos. So I have already installed this M.2 kit in one of the M.2 slots in my motherboard. This is a G370 chipset motherboard. If your motherboard has got multiple M.2 slots, I have got three, one and one will be beneath this graphic card and the other one is here. You can use any of the slot. Now I will install this hard disk drive also. So this hard disk drive is from Seagate. It's a 2 terabyte hard disk drive, 7200 RPM. After installing this, I will do the software installations and show you how to accelerate this drive. So this is the drive bay. I have already installed a 512 GB SSD wherein my operating system is already installed in this. And my second bay is empty. I will install the hard drive in this bay. Let me get this out. So this is I have taken the bay out. I will be aligning this four screws with these four holes already provided on the hard drive. However, before installing, make sure that the connectors are facing back side of the computer and not towards the front side. Just align the holes and one more here. Okay, once that is done, align this one here and the other one here. So it is pretty much done. Now let's fit this into the computer. Slide this in. There will be a click. That means it is properly installed. So that we'll connect the SATA cable to power this HDD with the power supply. After that, we'll connect this hard drive with the motherboard with a SATA cable. Route this cable to the front side. So here is an important thing to remember, that we cannot connect to any of the SATA ports here, 6 SATA ports here, as because we have already installed the Intel Optane memory in this M.2 slot. So this M.2 slot may be using one of the channels of this SATA ports. So refer your user manual, wherein there will be a diagram showing which M.2 slot will be sharing which channel of the SATA ports. So mine, if I have installed here, so my SATA port 0 will already be utilized. So I have to keep the SATA port 0 empty, and SATA port 1 is already used by my SSD. So I can connect the hard disk drive to any of the SATA ports which are empty. So once installation is done, we'll boot up the computer and install the softwares.
already booted up the computer. It has booted up without any issues. Now I will install the necessary softwares and do the disk management thing, and then we are all set to go. Let's go to the screen record mode.
First we'll do the disk partition and formatting of the hard disk which you have installed. So we'll go to the search, type disk management here. Sometimes disk management may not come and it will come as create and format hard disk partitions. Click on that. This will also take you to the same place. As you can see, my 16 GB Intel Optane memory is also displayed here. It may not display at the first instance because you need to install the software and drivers. I have already done that. That is why it is visible. And the disk one is the 2 terabyte hard disk drive. This red symbol, as you can see here, this means that the disk is not initialized yet. As soon as you open disk management, the initialization pop-up will automatically come. But sometimes if it doesn't come, then right click here and initialize disk, and then the pop-up will come. So use the following partition style for the selected disk. So what partition style you want to do? It may be MBR or it may be GPT. MBR is done for generally the older versions of computer, but nowadays for new computers, GPT is recommended. So select GPT and say okay. Once that is done, this red symbol will go away. So it is online now. After that, we'll do the hard disk format, and therefore we'll right click on it and select new simple volume. The wizard will pop out. Then next, click on next, let it be as is, next, here, let it be as is, next, then here, do not format this volume, format this volume. Yes, we want to format this volume as because this is a new hard disk. So you may either do, you have to keep it as NTFS because it's an internal hard disk. It leave it as new default, and what is the volume level. So what do you want to name the hard disk? I will name it as Seagate 2TB hard disk drive. So, and perform quick format or enable complete format. So if you select this, it will take around more than 1 hour to format the entire disk, but quick format will also do. So I will select quick format here and next, finish formatting and wait until it's done. Yeah, so we are done here. And for the Intel Optane, we don't need to do anything. We just need to initialize the disk and the status should come as online, and that is enough. After this, we'll install the driver and software for the Intel Optane memory. For that, we'll go to Google. Intel Optane memory driver. Go to the Intel link, downloads for Intel Optane memory drivers and softwares. Click on that. So you'll come to the list of all the drivers available for Intel Optane memory. Out of this, we need to select anything that says Intel Rapid Storage Technology User Interface and Driver. However, this is an older version. Always select the latest version. This is 16.83. You can also see there is one 17.9. This is also the same Intel Rapid Storage Technology Driver Installation Software with Intel Optane Memory. Okay, we'll click on this and this page will come up. And as of now, this is the latest version. In future, there may be more new updates, so you always select the latest version. And this is the driver. You need set up rst.axe, download this one, and these two are optional. You may or you may not download it, but this is compulsory. Once you click on download, I accept the terms, and it gets downloaded. So open. So it will take you to the Intel Rapid Storage Technology. The installation wizard has come up. It says you are about to install the following products: Intel Rapid Storage Technology driver that will work at the backend, and Intel Optane Memory and Storage Management application. This is the app through which you can manage the Intel Optane and do the acceleration process. And then click on next. I accept the terms. Next. Then next, click on this. If this is unticked, then click on this, because this means that during the installation process, it will also install the software app through which you can do the manage the obtained memory. Then click on next. So after restarting the computer, you have to go to search and type Intel. So app will already be installed. Click on that and it will open the app. For some guys, this software may not get installed automatically during the installation of the driver. In that case, you need to go to Windows Store and search Intel Optane. Just type Intel Optane and then enter. Just click on get and install the product. My product is already installed. Once the software and driver both are installed, you go to search button, type Intel, you get the application, click on that, yes, and the application will open up. So in the manage button, the application will show all the drives that are installed in your system. Mine is SATA SSD, wherein my operating system is installed, the hard disk drive which I have installed right now, and the Intel Optane memory which I have installed right now. In some cases, when you click on Intel Optane memory, you will status will be shown as inactive, and in that case, in place of mark as spare, it will be displayed as clear metadata. You have to click on that and clear the metadata, which means formatting the Intel Optane memory SSD. Once that is done, the status will get changed to normal and usage will be available. And when these two things are there, status normal and usage is available, the Optane memory is ready for use. Even if you go to disk management, if the status is inactive, you won't see the drive, the 16 GB drive here. So we need to go here, clear the metadata, change the status to inactive, from inactive to normal, and in that case, when we go back to disk management, and then Optane memory will be visible there. We don't need to do any setting changes in the BIOS while installing this driver and this software. The system will automatically make the necessary changes in the BIOS, and it will make Intel Optane memory ready. So once this is normal and usage is available, click on Intel Optane memory. It will show as status disabled. We have to enable it. For that, we need to select the Intel Optane memory through which we want to accelerate the hard drive, and to select a compatible drive to be accelerated. So mine one is it is by default selected as the SSD in which operating system is installed, but I will be accelerating the secondary hard drive. So I will select the hard drive, and after that click on enable Intel Optane memory. Now in the next page, it will prompt us erase all data. Now click on erase all data, enable. So during this process, all the necessary BIOS settings are being done at the backend. We don't need to change any settings in the BIOS. This software will and driver will automatically do it for us. So after restarting the system, go to Intel Optane memory application, click on yes. Now as you can see, my Intel Optane is paired with this hard disk drive, and it will act as a cache to the hard disk drive. This is a very simple process. No need to do any setting changes in the BIOS. This software and driver will automatically do all the necessary settings. We just need to install the hardwares, as I have shown in the earlier part of this video, and after that install the software, Intel Optane memory and store management, and also the driver, RST driver. And after also you need to do the partition and formatting of the hard disk drive in the disk management part. Hopefully it has cleared any doubts you might have, or if you have any further doubts, just write in the comment section. I will be happy to help you out. And I will also leave a link to the driver and application through which you can install it in your system.